Good morning, dear students. In the last previous video, we had discussed the definition of viscosity. So, just one second, I am recalling the definition here. By giving an example, I explained you the definition of the viscosity. What is exactly the viscosity? As I told you that if I let us consider a beaker which is filled with a fluid, it might be water or any liquid. When it is stirred with a rod, with a glass rod, when it is stirred, okay, so the fluid is going to be rotated continuously. Okay, due to this, a number of different layers of the liquid are going to be rotated with different velocities. The layers of the liquid which are just side to this beaker, they rotate with the least velocity. The layers of a liquid which sliding the sides of the beaker have the least velocity, and the layers at the center here, these layers of the liquid, they rotate with the high speed. So the least velocity, the layers which are having the least velocity, they always oppose the they always try to decrease the velocity of the fast moving layers. And these fast moving layers of the fluid, they try to accelerate the slow moving layers of a liquid. So one thing we can observe here, between these fast moving layers and these between the fast moving layers and the slow moving layers, there will be always one force which is always what it does, it opposes the motion. Okay, it is called as an opposing force. Okay, so we can call it as a viscous drag. Okay, viscous drag or an opposing force which always opposes the layers of the liquid to slow down. Okay, so just another one example of, as I told you that if I take a body, a solid body, and if I slide over a horizontal surface, then what happens? If I take a solid body and I just slide this body over the horizontal surface, then one force is always acting in the opposite direction. That force is called as a frictional force. It is called as a frictional force. It always opposes this body to move in the opposite direction. It will de-accelerate the body and this will move opposite to the frictional force. Okay, some force of friction is going to be developing between the body and this horizontal surface. Same way in liquid also it happens. Okay, so that property, the property of a liquid by virtue of which an internal friction comes into play with the different layers of a liquid when they are in relative motion, that property is called as a viscosity. It is called as a viscosity. Okay, and such force is called as a viscous drag, or also it is called as a frictional force. Force of friction. Okay. Such property of a liquid which is showing such properties called as a viscosity. Okay. So this is all about we have discussed in the last class, and I have given you the definition of the viscosity also. Now let us move on towards the next topic, that is coefficient of viscosity. Coefficient of viscosity. Okay. Now let us consider a liquid is flowing over the horizontal surface. Say for example, this is a horizontal surface. Over which a liquid is flowing. So, when the liquid is flowing, this is the flow of liquid in this direction, right? So, when the liquid is flowing means then it is moving with some velocity, right? So this fluid has a different layers. Say for example, these are the layers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 are the layers. So among these layers, just I considered these only 6 layers here. These are the layers of the fluid. Okay. Now among these, let us consider A, B, and C, D are the two layers of the liquid which they are moving in the forward direction, and here AB is moving with the velocity V, and here CD is moving with the velocity V plus D. Why I have taken this V plus DV here? This DV is a small increase in velocity. Okay, DV is it shows that there will be some small increase in the velocity. The below layer always what it will do? It will drag this, the fast moving layer, which always opposes in this direction, in the opposite direction, as I told you in this example. Okay, this AB layer, it always opposes the fast moving layer, and this fast moving layer, it always accelerates the slow moving layer. So that's why it is a fast moving layer, so that's why I take a V plus DV, and it is a small having a small velocity. It is a slow moving velocity layer, it has been taken as a V. Okay. So this force is going to be acted in the opposite direction. So now according to the Newton's, this viscous drag force or the force of friction, this is also, it is called as a force of friction, or also it is called as a viscous drag. Okay, it is always depending on the two factors. One is area. Okay, this viscous drag force depends on the two factors. One is area, and another one is velocity gradient. It is dV by dx. Velocity gradient. This viscous drag force is always directly proportional to the area and the velocity gradient. Okay. So in the form of equation, I am going to write here. This viscous drag force is directly proportional to area and the velocity gradient of the liquid. Okay. So if I remove this proportionality constant, it will be written as F is equal to minus eta A dV by dx. Here eta is called as the coefficient of viscosity, coefficient of viscosity. Here eta is called as a coefficient of viscosity. And here negative sign indicates that this negative sign, this above equation, this negative sign, it indicates that it always opposes the motion of a liquid in the opposite direction. This one, if the fluid is moving in this direction and the force of friction is acting in the opposite direction here, okay, that force of friction, either it might be due to this horizontal surface or due to the different layers. Okay, obviously it is due to the different layers only. Okay, they always drag this, the fast moving layers, in the backward direction. They always try to drag the fast moving layers in the backward direction. This might, you can observe, you can try it at your home. Okay, this example you can try it at your home and you can observe there. Okay, so same here it is what happening here. So this opposes the motion of liquid in the opposite direction. So that's why it decreases the speed of the layers. So that's why it has been taken as a negative sign. And here eta is called as a coefficient of viscosity. Okay, so this is what the equation for the force of viscous drag force. Here eta is called as a coefficient of viscosity. If here A is equal to 1 and dv by dx is equal to 1, then here F is equal to eta. If I just have to take a magnitude, then here viscous drag force is equal to the coefficient of viscosity when the area is per unit area and the velocity is, velocity gradient is per unit area. Okay, then the viscous drag force and the coefficient are both are equal here. That means they are perpendicular to each other here. The different layers are going to be perpendicular to each other here. So now next we move on towards the units of coefficient of viscosity. Coefficient of viscosity. So in CGS system, the unit of coefficient of viscosity will be, just I am rearranging this expression here, I have taken eta is equal to F divided by A into dv by dx. These are taken to the LHS side denominator here. So then here eta is equal to F divided by A into dv by dx. Okay. Now here I will write the unit of this force in CGS system. Now what is the unit of this force in CGS system? It is dyne. Okay. Now next we will be having, that is A. A means area. So that is area means centimeter square, and here dv by dx means, that is v is a velocity, dx is a distance. One thing here these, what are the two layers which I have considered? From horizontal surface to this AB surface is having how much distance? That is x. And from C, this second layer, that is CD, to this horizontal surface, it is having total, that is x plus dx. it is having dx. So total distance will be x plus dx, and here it is x. So and here it is dx. Okay. So here velocity means
divided by, that is centimeter. So then it will be dyne. So 1 centimeter will get cancelled. It is centimeter square per second. Then it can be as dyne second per centimeter square is the unit in CJ system, unit of coefficient in CJ system. Now in SI system, in SI system, here it will be eta is equal to dyne के जगह में यहाँ पे न्यूटन लेंगे, second का तो वही रहेगा second, and here it is centimeter and here it is meter. So this is for the unit of units of coefficient of viscosity in CJ system and in SI system. Okay. So this Newton second per meter square is the term, nothing but there is one decapoise. Okay, this is also called as one decapoise here. So just note on this one, units of coefficient of viscosity in CJ system and in SI system. You should remember these two units of coefficients of coefficient viscosity. So as I told you that, so it is in SI system, 1 Newton second per meter square. So one thing you should know that, just I told you that, 1 decapoise here. It is 1 decapoise is equal to 1 Newton second per meter square. Okay. So now, next, so next we'll be moving relation between poise and decapoise. As you know that one decapoise is equal to 1 Newton second per meter square. So as 1 Newton is in terms of dyne, if I write 1 Newton is equal to 10 to the power of 5 dyne. This is the number. 1 Newton is equal to 10 to the power of 5 dyne. So this is already you have discussed in units and measurement chapter. So you get to know 1 Newton is equal to 10 to the power of 5 dyne. So this is Newton and here it is second. It remains same. Meter, 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. So 100 means 10 to the power of square centimeter per second square. Okay, here are 1 Newton means 10 to the power of 5 dyne second. सेकेंड पर तो वही रहेगा यूनिट, यहाँ पे मीटर से हम सेंटीमीटर में कन्वर्ट कर रहे हैं, तो 10 टू द पावर ऑफ 2 सेंटीमीटर पर सेकेंड स्क्वायर. सो 10 टू द पावर ऑफ 5 डाइन सेकेंड, 10 टू द पावर ऑफ -4 सेंटीमीटर स्क्वायर. सो 5 माइनस 4 इट इज 1, इट इज 10 डाइन सेकेंड सेंटीमीटर square, which is 1 poise. 1 decapoise is equal to 10 poise. Okay. So this is what the relation between the poise and the decapoise. Okay. So this is all about in today's class we will discuss. In the next class we will discuss the new topics. Okay. Thank you very much.